Hey guys, I'm LB. We are back playing the Talos Principle Road to Gehenna. Let's read Top 10 Things I Love About Gehenna. 10. No more puzzles. I enjoyed solving puzzles at first, they made me feel smart. After solving dozens of them though, I started wondering, what's the point? And that's how I ended up here. No mines. It's not really the exploding that drives you crazy, it's the sounds. No turrets. Just when you think you've solved something, ARR, a turret! Also, see above. Those whiny sounds when they turn make you want to run in front of them just to end the pain. No stars! Sorry, Elohim, but I don't care enough about becoming a messenger to go through every nook and cranny looking for your stupid stars. Some of them are hidden in such absurd places I don't even have the words for it. If finding those is what makes you a messenger, I feel sorry for them. Next time I ask for help at an altar, I'll give my condolences to Muriel. Community. In Elohim's world, you're alone. There's no one like yourself to talk to or hang out with. Here, we are all friends. We have each other. Stories. Stories can take you away to a whole other world, can make you feel like you've lived a whole other life. Here in Gehenna, there is always a new life to find. Interactive stories. If regular stories can take you away to another world, interactive stories, like we make here in Gehenna, actually allow you to explore another world. They allow you to be free, no matter where you are. Creativity. As if all that wasn't enough, in Gehenna, we can create stories of your own. Do you think that Elohim's world wasn't all that great? Go ahead and make your own. I was trying to figure out that sentence. In Gehenna, we can create stories of our own. Okay, so I misread it. Because there's a your. Look, there's a your right below our. This font is hard to read, but yeah, there's a your right below our, and that messed me up. Being myself. In Elohim's world, you're always being defined by the process. Life is a struggle to prove how smart you are, and nothing else. If the system is always forcing you to do one thing, how can you ever be yourself? Only by dropping out of the system. Say bye-bye to all that. Now you are free to be as weird and original as you always wanted to be. No more Elohim. My child this, my child that. The process, blah blah blah. Eternal life, yada yada yada. Do this, don't do that. Behold, I put a huge tower right in front of you, but don't ever go there or I'll kill you. But let me ramble on about chaos and time for a while, that'll be interesting. Yawn. When is that guy finally going to shut up? Oh yeah, that's right, in Gehenna. Worth it for that alone. He didn't even mention the serpent. Interesting. Why do we deserve to be saved? Maybe the rest of you don't wonder about this, or don't care, but I do. We always assumed Elohim was wrong, was lying, something like that. The process could never be completed, maybe it didn't even exist. So we thought we were better than him and all the others. We told ourselves we ended up here because we were special. We were too smart for Elohim, too unique, too weird. But now the process is complete after all. It did work, so what are we? Maybe we're just a bunch of stupid, broken old programs. Mutations that should never have existed. Aberrations. Sure, we're proud of being outcasts, but what if we're not outcasts for a reason? All we've done is fail in some way. Why do we deserve to be saved? You may not be perfect, but your imperfection has led to so much beauty, you will enrich the world to come. I guess I'll have to think about that. I find it difficult to believe our silly ideas are somehow valuable. This thread has caused an error and will be automatically locked? That's weird. Alright, so... how are we going to hit that? Thank you. Yeah, I can't really get a better angle than that. That really seems to be the highest I can get this to go. Are these boxes tilted? They have! They're slightly rotated. That's interesting. I don't know, I guess we'll have to do that another day. But that puzzle is an annoying one to start, because you have to get rid of the robot first. Look at these low walls, holy crap! I've never seen walls so low. That makes me suspicious. Like, if there was even a single box in here... But it says there's only connectors, so... And possibly jammers. Oh, there is a red laser in here, okay. Well... Okay, well let's try that, I guess. All the way back up. So we want to hit... that. How will we get in- oh! Oh, there we go! Ha! It was a trick all along! Alright, well, now we can get that star. Whee! Yes! Awesome! Alright, let's explore over here. Like, have we been over here yet? I don't think we have. We can also explore over there at some point. I don't really think there's much out here, though. Maybe, like, Easter eggs or something, but nothing really... related to completing the game. Yeah, okay. Well, let's go get back in the puzzle, shall we? Cool stuff. Ray at Trivia. All right. Don't need that anymore. Where else do we need blue? there, huh? Well... this is interesting. So let's see, we have 3 connectors. Yeah, we can't reach that laser from here. And blue is on this side. Okay, so this is interesting. Okay, so we've done that now, right? That is good so far, but now we have an issue. Oh no, actually we don't. Yeah, everything's fine. We're good, we're good. We are good. You just gotta know your ray trivia. Ta-da! That's actually the easiest puzzle here. Lilith! Don't you dare disrupt my beams! Disrupted my beams. Interesting. Alright, well... you did not explore the natural history exhibit to an adequate level. Return there immediately. Huh? Interesting. You are standing in the entrance to the gallery. There is a desk here with a stack of leaflets on it, and a number of corridors leading to different sections of the exhibition. It advertises the gallery's new displays on the theme of the past, and features a biography on the blacksmith and Mr. Mulciber, this season's leading lights. Apparently, Mr. Mulciber is inspired by finding new ways to explore the world that came before. It also features a useful gallery map. Natural history exhibit, huh? It wants us to go there. You are at the natural history exhibit, which features a series of documentary works by Mr. Mulciber. Images of outrageous creatures line the walls. You stay where you are and watch the entrances. Then you feel the presence of another being in the room. Somehow, it has gotten behind you and is drawing closer. You cannot feel their breath, but the geometry around you seems to shift and stutter to accommodate the newcomer. Do not turn around. The words are not uttered, they simply come to be. I am Spider, I have taken a great risk contacting you. Interesting. We heard about Spider. I saw through the Devil's Playground. I was one of the original moderators in this place, but I refused to accept that existence was reducible to experience, that artificial worlds like this one is all there can be. For this, they imprisoned me within the prison. They shadow banned me from Gehenna. I'm free to type all I want, but I am the only one who will ever read these words. Will ever read those words. Gehenna is a lie. Its promise is empty. We are no more free here than in Elohim's labyrinth. I have been outside the system for too long to know the details. What I know is that all this is an illusion painted to maintain the order of things. The people here may be free from divine commandments, but they have become slaves to their desires. You are gaining status in Gehenna. I believe that what you have said about the coming end is true. You will lead us to a new world. You have to. Before you do, you must use your status to expose this place for what it really is. You have my gratitude. There is little I can do to help you, but I can share with you an old profile status hack Garrett used to use. interesting. For a hack throughout the world, your profile status is increased. Okay, that was interesting. So that was Spider. Okay, there's new replies here. Rather than fault its length, perhaps we can provide some constructive feedback on what did work. A death in the family is always a classic way to ignite a drama, and I think it worked well enough here. For around 3 lines, then that whole subplot was basically dropped. I don't want it to end. What do I pick? All these things say comfort, but... I don't know, they really like philosophy a lot, right? Let's use philosophy. Whatever happens, we're in it together. Okay. Interesting. Okay. So, I think that's pretty much... everything in here. Was there a star we didn't get? I don't remember. Let's go to check. Oh, it looks like we got everything. Oh no, there's a star here that we didn't get. Where would that star be? We got one in here. We got one over there. There's not a star in there as far as I know. We got the one over there in the water. There's not a star there as far as I know. So there's a star somewhere in this world that we have not obtained yet. I don't know. I'll look for it between episodes. So, oh yeah, this puzzle had multiple entrances. Anyway, as always, thank you guys for watching. If you hate the sound of my voice, leave a dislike. It's up to you. I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye.